Rikita Dozier.
Hallelujah. Come on, I need some blood-washed believers to praise God tonight with me. Come on, everybody on your feet. Everybody on your feet. If you're able to stand tonight, I need you to worship with me. Come on, come on. Begin to put your hands together tonight. Anybody know we serve an awesome God? Anybody know we serve such a great God? Come on, if you know the Lord is good, let me hear you scream tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tonight I just come to encourage somebody that no matter what you're going through, begin to trust God. In every situation you're going through, begin to trust Him. Amen. Do I have anybody in the building that's willing to trust Him tonight? Hallelujah. If you trust Him, let me just hear you say hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. dependable. Yeah. Come on, somebody worship. And now trust you, Lord. Oh, you are accountable. You are dependable. And I trust you, Lord. Oh, you are accountable. Come on, somebody worship. You are dependable, and I trust you, Lord. Come on, somebody put your hands together. Hallelujah. Anybody know we serve an awesome God? Come on, come on. I can see all the worshipers in the building. Put your hands up. Hallelujah. Come on, I know we may not be in a church, but we are the church. And if we just begin to worship, God will break some chains. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Just begin to lift your hands and worship him tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is there anybody in the building that's willing to do anything for the glory of God? I don't know about you all, but if I have to let go of some people or let go of my past to get to where God is taking me, we have to do that tonight. And I just come to encourage you that no matter what the situation may be, you can trust God and let go of what you need to let go for the glory of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, just begin to worship the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Come on, I want to see your hands lifted, your mouths open. Hallelujah. God, we worship you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody.
If I find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be
do.
Everybody begin to worship. I gotta be where you are. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. Somebody help me say, I wanna be where. Come on, I'ma push you a little bit further. Say, I gotta be where.
Again, bringing to the stage the lovely ladies of Orchestra's Dance Ensemble. Put your hands together as they come.
Hallelujah. Here now, you must come to South Africa. Jumping, jumping, Cape Town. Come to South Africa with me, yeah. All around, everywhere I look, your love is all around, everywhere I look, your love is all around.
Everywhere.
Your love is too deep to navigate. And it's too high to climb. But still it's available. Time after time. After time, after time. After time, your love lifted me. It's too deep to navigate. It's too high to climb, oh, 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 but still, still it's available. Yes. Time after time, after time, after time, after time. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? Your love is all around. Everywhere I look, your love is all around. And you say,
everywhere I look, your love is all around. Everywhere I look, your love is all around.
Come on, come on, come on.
Everywhere I look, your love is all around. Everywhere I look, your love is
all around. One more time, say, all around.
All around.
Yeah.
All around.
Everywhere I look,
come on and let's bless God together as we welcome the uplifting sounds of BCU Voices to the stage.
No matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more, more and more,
more and more,
more and more.
More and more,
ooh, yeah, more and more.
the chains over our life, God. We want to break the chains over our life, God. God, we want you to break out the chains in our life, God. The chains over our finances, the chains over our grace, God. We lift your name up higher and higher and higher. Lord, we lift your name up higher.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power.
Break every chain. 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 Break every chain.
Everything to you. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Lift your hands tonight. Come on, lift your hands tonight. Come on, I then just begin to close your eyes and meditate on God.
Say everything. You're everything to me. You're everything to me.
You're everything to me.
You're my
peace. You're my peace.
Come on, don't talk to us. Tell God you're everything to us.
You're everything to me.
Joy and sorrow.
Joy and sorrow.
Come on, just talk to him. Say you're everything to me, God. Every.
You're everything to me.
Say hope for tomorrow.
Now we need y'all to help us right here. Come on and lift your voice and say, Master.
Master.
Come on and say,
Savior.
Healer. When the doctor told me I had diabetes, he
Savior, what is it? The only name that can raise you, what is it? The only name that can protect you. Hey, come on and call his name. Say Jesus. Hey, the name that's been provided for you. I know somebody knows the name beside me. Say Jesus.
Come on, he's here, he's here. Come on, bow. Come on, bow.
I bow before the King.
His presence so holy. Bow, bow.
Bow before the King.
I'm not worthy to stand in his presence. I bow.
Bow before the King.
He died for me. I must bow. I must bow.
Bow before the King.
When they said I was gonna die, I must bow. I must bow.
Bow before the King.
When they took all my money away, I must bow. I must bow. Come on, come on. It's a king you in the presence of. Come on, it's a king you in the presence of. It's a king that you in the presence of. I dare you to just bow your head. You're in the presence of a king right now. Oh, he's here. Oh, he's here. Oh, he has bowed. I dare you. I dare you to bow. I dare you to bow your head. Worship him, worship him, worship him.
friends, her ministry, none other than the Leandria Johnson.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank God for being here tonight, and we thank God for allowing us to be here and travel safe getting here. And it's a privilege to be able to praise God with you all and worship God with you all. But if y'all don't mind, if can we turn the lights on? I like to see my brothers and sisters. If y'all don't mind, some folk like this atmosphere. And then you can take these off me right here so I can see you. Amen. Is that better? I thank God again, and the wonderful staff that has brought us here. Y'all, let's give them a hand clap for allowing us to be here. How many know it takes a sacrifice when you're on a mission? A lot of us have sacrifices that we often have to go through, and trials and tribulations that we have to pass, test and everything. But look at your neighbor and say, you're sitting next to a survivor. You're sitting next to an overcomer, a winner. Some folk in here may have the testimony that some people thought or had the audacity to tell you in your face that you would never amount to anything. Some folk have the audacity to spread your business and to tell the next person your ups and your downs. Some folk, you may be sitting in here and be like, I was just in the club with her, and how's she gonna be doing this? Or I was just drinking and smoking with her, how's she gonna do this? Or we was just, you get what I'm saying? But when you have your own relationship with God, that's all that matters. How many churchgoers in here? Y'all young, y'all get what I'm saying. I just got to the point where I was sick and tired of going to church and looking at the church people and hear them criticize, talk about, gossip, scandalize, and do what they wanted to do because they were in high position. And then when it come down to them doing their dirt, you get what I'm saying? So that's why I had to step out aside a little bit. Some of you know my story. I was one of the ones. My dad is a bishop, mother is a pastor. I'm in church, had to do praise and worship, but my spirit wasn't there. My flesh was, but my spirit wasn't. So Saturday night I was in the club, dancing and drinking, getting stinking drunk. Sunday morning come, I got to lead praise and worship. A lot of people didn't understand that. Well, I just saw her. Yeah, you did see me there, and you was there too. So I was being rebellious, not knowing that, it could have been, a little wrong, my dad being pastor and all that kind of stuff, not knowing that. But I wanted to do me because I didn't want to be fake. So I wasn't singing because I was a praise and worship leader. I was singing because I had my own relationship with God. While they was talking about me, 3 o'clock in the morning, 5 in the morning, I was praying and asking God to deliver me and forgive me for the things that I've done. Then, before I got married, I had a baby out of wedlock. I guess that would be the number one no-no in a church. And then they wanted to silence me, and they wanted to sit me down, and they wanted to say all this and all that. And I looked them in the face, Bishop on down. I said, you can't put me in hell. You can't tell me to stop serving God. You can't tell me no. Why? Because you're not God. You don't understand my story. You don't understand. And I'm not condoning anything, but I had to stand for another woman that may be pregnant out of wedlock and that feels that she needs to commit suicide because she can't go on, or feels like she can't come to church because somebody's going to be looking at her. But look at your neighbor and say, don't judge me. Pray for me. And if we had enough young people that are in church, if we had enough of y'all to be in church and be like, listen, I am who I am. No disrespect to y'all, but I am who I am. But I'm gonna need you to back off me because I do know Christ for myself. It's quiet. A lot of people don't like it. But you gotta be real and you gotta tell it like it is. So that's why we come tonight. I have my brothers that are playing, my husband, my sister, my brother-in-law, my sister, my cousins. Everybody is here, and we just come to minister to each other. Is that all right? So just for a few minutes, I want you to just think about where you are right now. And if you are happy where you are right now, then thank God. But if you're not happy where you are right now, just take out 2 minutes and talk to God for yourself. And say, God, I need you to be in control. I need you to take care of this situation. So just for a few minutes, go ahead on and talk to God just for a few minutes. Can you help me say hallelujah? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
may not be where I need to be.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're so worthy. You're so worthy.
See, that was for me. I can't just go before the Lord any kind of way. I gotta ask God to forgive me and get on my knees and give him reverence in spite of what the atmosphere looks like. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You could have opted out. Because the enemy knew that you had a blessing right around the corner, but you said, God, it's more than this. So by you being obedient to the will of God, God say everything that you need him to do in this season, all he say, write it out, make it plain, and it is yours. Why? Because you know who God is. God say your worries are over because of your heart.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I don't know about y'all, but I feel the Holy Ghost in here.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
Come on, can you hear me say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Come on, one more time. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
No, no clapping, no clapping. Right now, just for 2 minutes, just open up your mouth and just thank God, just for 2 minutes. If you've been praying for something that you want God to do, claim it right now in those 2 seconds. But you gotta have faith. Open up your mouth and talk to God. Come on, talk to him. Talk to him like you need him. Talk to him like you need him. Because God will take care of you. Talk to him, talk to him. God will take care of you. God will take care of you. Those hands that are lifted, God hears your earnest cry. Be not dismayed. Whatever, ever, ever. Whatever betide, God will take.
Yeah. Church, when the pastor they get ready to preach here, look at you and say, set your neighbor, say, neighbor, if you don't know like I know what the Lord has done for me, no, you got to do it like you're preaching, like the Lord has done for me. Say, I know He will. High five three people and say, I know He will. Yeah. Oh, you ought to reach past your neighbor and say, I know He will. How y'all feeling back here? Y'all ought to make some noise back here if y'all feel it. Listen. There is somebody in the house that have not forgave others or themselves. I'ma keep singing. But y'all know it's ministry with me, right? I'ma sing. I feel some folk. I ain't asked her to come here and do all that. Hey, it is what it is. I can't come in and just perform and walk out like, you know, other people's lives don't matter. You get what I'm saying? It's easy for me to sing all of the songs on the album and leave. That, hey, I can't do that. So there is somebody in here that have not forgave others or themselves. Where are you? Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Meet me right here, and we're going to walk up there together. Don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. God is a forgiving God. This is what it's all about, breakthrough, right? The Lord wants to prepare you for your own business. He's trusting you for your own business. Your days of answering to man are over. Some folk want to hold you here, but they don't know what you go through there. But God said he's trusting in you with what he already told you to do. Look at all these people that want deliverance. There's a song my grandmother used to sing. I know prayer changed things. I know prayer, yeah, changed things. Been to prayer will change things. Come on, y'all follow me on my way up here. Are there any pastors here? Come on, come on, come on, come on. Because what the devil meant for bad, God meant it for your good. Yeah, yeah. My God today. I ain't gonna go there. Sweet Holy Ghost, I felt a praise break, but I'm not gonna do it right there. I felt a praise break. Don't push it, cuz we'll praise break. You know what? Give them a 2-minute praise break while we walking up here on the altar. 2-minute praise break. Come on. Oh, y'all ain't got you gotta know. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him. You want to praise him, you need to praise him, you want to praise him, you need to praise him. I will praise him, praise the Lord, praise him. Look at that. The breakthrough is already happening. The breakthrough is already happening.
I just need about 5 or 7 people out there to open up your mouth and say, it is so. Look at that. Look at that. Sometimes all you gotta do is be sensitive to the spirit. Hey! This shay I love my heart. I heard the Lord say, it's 10 people out here. If you just make your way out of your seat and you go take a lap, God said he'll supply everything that you need in the supply. 1, 2, 3, huh? Oh, you better get it. You better get it. Don't let nobody stop you. Oh! Hug her right there and tell her everything that you need is done. Ooh, yeah. I see, sir. I see you. I see it. I see it. Sometimes you gotta see it before you see it. You gotta see that thing. You gotta see yourself out of that depression. You gotta see yourself out of trouble. You gotta see yourself out of bondage. You gotta see yourself out of the pit. Somebody ought to praise God. Somebody ought to praise. Started. Pastors, you can take this side, you can take the middle, and you take the left hand side. Listen, right now you lift your hands right now and say, God, I'm sorry. And Lord, I thank you for another chance to be forgiven and allowing me another chance to forgive. As they lay hands on you, I want you to not stop until you feel the hand of the Lord on your life. And I need y'all out here to push them. I need you to make a thunderous applause out here that God is doing what he said he would do. And that is never leave you nor forsake you. He will always be there through the thick and the thin. Somebody ought to praise God for them. Hallelujah! Oh God, oh God. My God, how many want to be endowed from on high? There's still somebody else. It's not too late. It's not too late. What time is it? What time is it? Okay. The director that's over the... Oh, endow me. Softly, softly. Softly, softly. Yes. Softly, softly. Yeah. Lord. Look at that. My God, keep working.
Endow me.
Are you really prepared for what you did tonight, what God did through you tonight? Let me tell you something. Now you see why the enemy had to stick his head in. There is a lot of young people out here in this house tonight. I hear the Lord say, crusade. If she put on, well, let me say, if we put on a crusade here in Daytona, how many people will come back? Let me hold on. I don't think y'all understand what I'm saying. How many people in here can travel? I just need a few people to be able to travel around this country to let other young people know, listen, you shall live and not die. How many understand that? The world needs to know that there's somebody, there's some praises in Daytona. There's some praises in Daytona. There's some over. Do you see this? Oh, Lord. And down. I want you to come get, I want you to get laid hands on because, and your team, bring your team up here. Because God is getting ready to change your life because of obedience. You didn't have to do this. You didn't have to do this. My God, but God trusted you with these souls. You got somebody good on your team. She could have, but the Holy Ghost, look at the tears, my God. See, I want y'all to see what's going on. Yes, my God. The tears are sincere. But I hear the Lord say, if you just wait just a little while longer, I need y'all to point up here, and I need y'all to just tell them just to wait a little bit longer. Ask me why. Because when you wait on them, the blessings come when unexpected. They come when you're not thinking about them anymore. When you wait on them, am I right, Elder Best? Come up here, Elder Best. When you wait on them, God will answer the things that you pray for and the things that you forgot that you prayed for. Are you ready, team? The Lord said, get a name. There need to be a name for this group. God said he wants you to get a name for this group. You need to be known as one entity. And guess what? Those that were supposed to help you, that didn't help you, now they're going to look and they're going to marvel. And they're going to say, I wish I never gave in the tower. I wish I never threw in the towel. See, what God wants, he wants some people that is not so quick to give up. God wants some people that's willing to fight the fight of faith. No matter how high the fire is, God wants somebody to stand. Look at your neighbor and say, just stand. If you stand, the blessing will be right around the corner. So I want y'all to get in a circle. I want y'all to grab hands. And I want y'all to talk amongst yourself. I want you to ask yourself, what do you want God to do for you in 2014? And 15, what are your goals? What is your long-term goals, your short-term goals? Anybody in here have a degree? Anybody working on a degree? You're working on a degree? Tuition, money, finances, financial aid? Right now is the time to ask God for what you want. See, when you do ministry, God will do you. If you put God first, he'll supply all of your needs. It's not meant for us to worry about man-made things. It's not meant for us to worry about what people think we should be worrying about. If we put God first, he'll handle it. So a couple of minutes, y'all talk amongst each other, and y'all try to find out what y'all need out of this year. And we're going to cover you in the name of Jesus. It comes. You know me. You got hands bowed here. Tears are falling here. For those that have been thinking about suicide, get it out your brain, because it's not meant for you. I don't care if you knew people that committed suicide. Just because you knew them and they committed suicide, it doesn't mean that you have to go down that route. You got to start talking to yourself. You got to start saying, I'm more than a conqueror. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthened me. There is a will and a work for my life. Every morning when you wake up, you got to say, God, why did you allow me to live this day? And your answer should be, because God, there is a will for you to do. There's a will for me to do. You got to understand that we're not just living this life just to be living this life. God wants us to worship him. He wants us to praise him. He wants us to lift him up. He wants us to magnify him. If you are not saved tonight, if you are not saved tonight and you want God in your life tonight, you ought to jump up here right quick. You ought to make your way up here. If you realize that you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, and now you are ready for God to take control of your life, you ought to meet me right up here. Don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. There are some men in here that don't like what they used to do. They don't like what they used to be. They don't like the fact that they got to sell drugs. drugs. They don't like the fact that they gotta smoke drugs. You meet me up here tonight and watch God do what he do. There are some women in here that feel like they let too many men in and out of their life. People made a name for you. I've been there, I've done that. Make your way up here. And if you want God to change your life, make your way up here. Don't you be afraid. You don't know when God is coming back. You don't know how long it's going to be for you to be here. You don't know the day nor the hour that the Son of Man is going to appear. You don't know. But what you do know is that the breath that you are breathing right now could be that very same breath to say to God, I'm sorry. God, forgive me. God, I want to do your will. God, I want to pray. God, I want to read the Bible. God, I want you to use me like never before. If that's you, you meet me up here right now. And know me.
And know me.
Some of you women, you're being physically abused by a man. You don't have to take it. Some of you men, you don't feel like you could get a job because you got a felony on your record. I serve a God that is better than that. Sometimes you just got to allow God to be God. Don't worry about the record. God holds the ultimate record. Hello?
Lord,
look at them. They're coming. They're still coming. This is why I tell you it's about ministry. Some of y'all worried about child support. Listen, God is the best child support that you can ever have. All you gotta do is give it to the Lord and say, God, endow me. They're making their way. There is still somebody that is still contemplating whether they want to give their life over to God. Let me tell you something. As long as you live without him, you can't make it with him. You got to get to a point in your life where you say, God, I live. For you, I live. For you, I live. Get your flesh out of the way. Get your flesh out of the way. You got to think about it. It's not you that wake you up in the morning. It's God, grace and mercy that he gave you. Brand new mercy each day. In the midst of your own decision, it's the Lord that is covering you. When we want to go left, when he told us to go right, God never leaves us. He's always there. He's just wanting you to open up your heart and your mind and receive him. There is still somebody that needs to be up here. And know me. Pastors, those that are walking up, just lay hands and we're getting ready to believe God for the impossible.
Lord.
Nothing too hard for God. He sees your tears. He hears your crying. The Lord is with thee. 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 Yes, he is. The Lord is with thee. In the name of Jesus. Cover our mind, God. Cover our mind, God. Cover our heart, God. Cover our heart, God. In the name of Jesus.
Lord,
give us strength to endure the wiles of the enemy. Endow me, Lord.
Endow me.
That's it. Rest in him. Rest in him. That's it. He's taking control. Rest in him. Rest in him. That's it. Rest in him. That's it. Let him have his way. Let him have his way. Let him have his way. Oh, rest in him. And now the order. Jesus. There's a sweet spirit in this house. There's a sweet spirit in this house. Oh, come on. Glory to God. Yes. This is my brother. This is my blood brother. And let me tell you something. He got a testimony himself. All of my brothers got a testimony. But it's about men and women linking up together. Sometimes it takes another man to look another man in the face and say, hey, we got to be about this thing. However y'all do it. How y'all do it? We got to be about this thing. You get what I'm saying? Do you believe what God wants to do in your life? Do you accept what God wants to do in your life? Do you know that you can be greater than what you think that you can be? Do you know that you have the opportunity to break the cycle? Do you know that the cycle ends with you? That God has a higher calling in your life? Do you know that your seed will be blessed because of the next decision that you make? How many know that your seed will be blessed by the next decision that you make? Are you ready? Are you ready? You're going to shake his right hand. And when you shake his right hand, I want you to lift your hands up and say, God, I'm ready. You hear what I'm saying? I want you to say, God, I'm ready. And if you know anybody else in here, that's one of your homies, tell them to meet you up here because God got something coming for me. Sometimes you got to tell yourself that. Say, God got something coming for me. Say it. Say it. Say it. Shake his right hand and tell God I'm ready. Somebody ought to rejoice with him.
Jesus.
Somebody else in here had a hard knock life. Somebody in here, civilization, society said that you would never amount to anything. You got black men being shot for playing loud music. You got black men being shot for being black men. It's time for us young people to pray together, to stand together. Matter of fact, every black man, I don't care where you at. Come up here. You need to be covered in the blood of the name of Jesus. Make your way. Let me take every black man. Come on up here. The devil is alive. He think he just gonna be a punk and shoot me because I'm black. I'm tired of that foolishness.
Jesus.
It's more to a black man than just being a black man. Hello?
Jesus.
Some of y'all think this is funny. Some of y'all don't think that this should be going on. But let me tell you something. What if that was your son that was shot? What if that was your brother or nephew or grandson that was shot?
Jesus.
It's time for the people of God to pray. I don't know if you know, That first incident happened in Jacksonville, right? And there was somebody else that got shot in Orlando. I don't know if y'all heard about that. But here we are, just what, 45 minutes to an hour away from Orlando? We black men gotta stick together. When I say we, y'all know what I mean, right? I want y'all to grab hands. Your faith tonight, God uses you. He hears your prayer. I need y'all to stand in for every black man that has been shot, for the enemy that is trying to steal the minds of the black men, the enemy that is trying to destroy the black men. You got black men that really are not mature enough yet. They think the gun is the way out. It is not the way out. But we're going to go into prayer. Pastors, I believe God tonight that the cycle ends with you. And on the count of three, we're just going to go into prayer. And we're going to believe God. Amen. And if you would, we all should pray on the count of three. One, two, three. Let's pray.
Jesus.
Jesus,
call upon him,
Jesus,
one more time.
give God praise in this house. That's it. Let her praise him. Let her praise him. Let her praise him. Let her praise. You don't know what they've been through. You don't know their story. Sometimes this is what it takes. Oh! I feel another praise break. God got you covered. I feel another praise break. Hey! This reminds me of back in the day in revivals. Y'all know what about revivals? When you throw in a revival, you got people laid out at the altar. You know they used to call it altar call. They used to call it altar call. If nothing but one soul get back saved, that's what we want. Oh! One, two, three, four.
Y'all see it?
I need somebody to meet me in Gainesville on March 17th, 18th, and 19th. If y'all got school, I understand. But y'all can go to school in the day. I don't know how that go. And then drive. How many people would... Okay, listen, I'm like dead serious. It's time to take over. It's time to take over. New Beginnings Church of God by Faith in Gainesville, Florida. We're going to be in our Position and Power Conference. Y'all need to come. I want y'all to come too. God, my God, my brother. Yeah, buddy. So who will be free in March? So we need to get a bus, right? You will? Those who want to go, before you leave, listen, I got a notepad in the car. I knew I bought it for a reason. If we can have somebody go run and get that for you, we're going to get your name, your number, and your email address. Y'all ready to take over? I'm serious. It ain't nothing but a bunch of young folk getting with another bunch of young folk that love God. Do y'all know what happened? Who band are y'all with? I like that. I said, who band y'all with? We're all over. Yeah. I like that. Y'all live in the same place. I love it. I love it. Listen, that's my husband. That's my brother, Leroy, my brother, Michael, my brother, Terrence. It's a whole family thing. Y'all welcome to the family. Y'all ready to go on tour? See? I know y'all ready. I'm trying to tell you, I need a Live Nation crew. Right? Bobcats? Hold on. Okay, y'all can do that to me. Wah, wah, wah. You did it. Wildcats. I'm so sorry I said Bobcats. I'm so sorry. Y'all don't hate me. Don't hate me. I had one, two, I think three of my family members graduated from Bethune-Cookman. Yes. Alice Dean, well, they're older. Alice Dean and my Uncle Edgar, Amanda and Angela, my cousins. I have my cousin here, Angel, raise your hand. Another graduate of Bethune-Cookman here. So I got folk there, rep. Angel, you heard me? Bobcats, Jesus. But I love y'all tonight. Yes? Whistle? Anything for y'all? Anything. So, okay. No, do something else. Whistle. I'm going to whistle, but do something else, honey. Something else. I don't know. Okay, and I got your request. And she said we was good, but if we got to go, just let us know. Okay. I ain't did that in a minute. Don't pick it. Don't pick at me. Love you, too. Yes, I love you too. Mm. No, I gotta tune it in. Mm. Sing, sing. That's good. Oh.
Have y'all heard of Tim Rogers and the Fellas? Tim Rogers and the Fellas? This their sister, Tally Rogers. Just give them a little bit, Tally. Just a little bit, Tally. Somebody say, sing, Tally. Y'all can come sign now.
Holding on until you see the sun. Gotta keep on holding on. Holding on until you see the sun comes. Gotta keep on.
Does Daytona have a citywide choir? I just need to know, does Daytona have a citywide choir? So that means all the choirs that are in Daytona, there is no citywide choir. Can we form a citywide choir tonight? Sopranos, make some noise. All right, I want y'all to see what I'm trying to do. All right, I need a piece of paper for sopranos, altos, and tenors. We just made a Daytona citywide choir tonight. And we gonna go into the studio and we gonna record. Y'all ain't ready. Who y'all was saying sing? Who? Come on up here. Yeah, they can come up, baby. Yeah. Look at this line. Y'all gonna really come to Gainesville? All right. We're gonna have a hot time. Oh! Y'all ready? Holding on. Where's my brother Michael at? Using the bathroom? When he get back, tell my brother to come out here on this stage. Y'all say, Michael. Oh, there he goes. Boop. Y'all, he don't like when I say my baby brother, but this my baby brother, y'all, Michael. Yes, he gonna sing a little bit for you. Can my baby brother sing something for y'all? So I just need somebody to say, sing, Michael! Ah. Yeah.
Holding on.
Sing, Michael.
Holding on.
Yes, it's on. Loop that thing.
Holding on. I gotta keep holding on. I gotta keep holding on. Holding on. Holding on. Help me say hold it.
Holding on. Holding on.
I must hold on. Yes. Anybody feel like holding on?
Holding on.
And to God's the changing hand, yeah. Until
you see the sun,
you gotta keep.
Listen to Michael, they call her from down there, Michael. They call her, so we're gonna see what they got. We're gonna see what she got.
Oh no, holding on. Said I gotta keep holding on. Holding on. Holding on.
Jesus.
Oh, no, no.
Stand on over there with the leaders. Lord have mercy. Robert, y'all want to hear my road manager sing?
Yeah. Holding on. Yeah, Jesus. Yeah, I'll just say.
Tanika. All right, let's get down to business. Let's get down to business. Hit me. 1, 2, 3. Putting on the plan. All right. Now, these are the people that's coming to Gainesville, but I'm trying to get this choir together too now.